As you look at the Gospel of John, something you could monopolize or control. Being born again was something that happened to you. God's Spirit gives you new perspective. I bought these omega pills. They're in, like, I don't know if you guys can imagine, you're of course here. And I had a bottle of cream, but the imagery is everything, right? But I mean, like, they were weighing my back, they were lagging me from that home. I went to see my doctor, and my doctor said, we just need to give them to take omega pills, and I trust my doctor. So I went to the store, and I bought a bottle, but the bottle was dark. I didn't know what the pills would look like inside when I bought the bottle. So I got the bottle home, and I took the pills out these big, I can't think of the other word, these big pills. And so I don't know, maybe I have a small passageway, I don't know. But I could not swallow new tack-on pills. I mean, I've tried to include it, but I mean, I am psychologically messed up. I even wrote the company and said, your pills are too big. They wrote me back, they put it in the mail, send them back to us, we'll give you your money. I imagine when Nicodemus was listening to Jesus, he was finding it was a hard pill to swallow. He asked two times kind of the same question, and when people ask you the same question, that means they didn't get it the first time around. So what are you trying to say, Jesus? He's just not getting his language and lingers in the literal understanding of birth. Reverend John Allen argued, Jesus is asking Nicodemus to be born in a new way, to be born from above, to bear God's logic amongst a world that functions astray from the will of the divine. Jesus is asking Nicodemus to be on the ground floor of something new, to turn away from what has been done before, to turn away from the rules and logic that have ordered his life up to this point, to emerge into the world. I imagine some of us would be born again to it. I could go with that. All this born again talk is worth mentioning because it allows us to expand our vision and see and feel differently. In my coming of age experience, I have powerful experience of God leading me at a depressing moment in my life. Being a teenager is hard work. Those are some hard years. I mean, you're socially alienated from adults because you think you know it all and they repulse you. And then you're trying to be cool among your peers and you can't let them know that really you don't know. Teenager is rough. And it really was at that moment in time where we moved across the United States all the way from San Francisco to Virginia, from suburban to rural, that I needed God. And I felt God calling me also. Born again for me felt like a new lease on life, and that God really cared about me personally. And that's where the last two verses take us, in this winding road we're on with Jesus, because Jesus has taken over this conversation. We are reintroduced to this notion that God loved us so much, that God sent God's Son, and God did not come to condemn us, so people need to stop using this text to exclude or isolate others. It's not God's agenda. God loves all people. God loves the people fearful of deportation. God loves the people that live on the other side of the walls that we have constructed literally and mentally and politically. I know this one's going to be hard for you to believe, but God loves the Democrats and the Republicans.
Oh, no.
This one is going to be even harder. God loves the Bernie and the Warren and the Biden supporters. He's going to be in our criminal justice system as bad and criminal. God loves those people. God loves those that are stopped often while they're driving for nothing other than the look of their vehicle or the color of their skin. God loves those people. God loves the women who continue to march and the women who can't afford to march. God loves us all. God loves the Muslims and those, including the atheists,
Jesus was ready for the visitor when the visitor arrived. And Jesus starts in on him. And that's our cue. That's our line. That's our motto. As followers of Christ, hey, God loves you this much. And because people don't believe words, you got to show people. Because words can be very shallow. God loves you this much. No condemnation here.
joys or concerns. Yes, Denise.
Welcome back. I had a great time in D.C. It's surprising my girls were getting 40 birthday parties. So that was a call. She saw me. She's boo-boo and rock. And the other one is Donald, a friend of mine. Also, I volunteered at another church. And you see the call in D.C. and she died. She had a mom there. She died. And she's praying for the Washington family to go through this sudden death. And also, I want to thank the children for being, you know, giving me a call and being able to be doing my time on staff with them. So, Denise just is joyful about being able to pull off a surprise to her daughter that she knew nothing about for her birthday party, as well as lifting up to your friend who succumbed to the pneumonia and praying for that family as well. Come home, Spirit.
I have a joy that the quilt show is coming, as we mentioned before. How can you help? Look at your bulletin. One way is by supporting the quilt show by being a patron, the form of your bulletin. Publicity. On the back table, there are flyers, postcards, bookmarks. Please take some, share them with people, pass the word. And also, if you can give some time the week of the quilt show, Laura will have sign-up sheets available during coffee hour. We need your help.
So there's a form in your bulletin that you can fill out. You can help with publicity. There's so many ways to publicize. There's many ways you can pick up some papers on the back table. You can use social media. And last, you can use some hardcore bodies when the day is actually here. There's multiple ways. Come home and hear it. About really taking seriously. Come home.
Let us pray. We are reminded that God doth go before us as we leave this space, but never ever God's presence as we walk on this journey of Lent. Lord, help us to welcome the visitor and to share the good news. In Jesus' name, all God's people say,
Amen.
Amen.